Okay, student, again, good morning to all of you. And yesterday we are studying locating places on the earth and finding times. And we are come to know that what is globe? A globe can be defined as a miniature form or a spherical representation of the earth. Okay, it's a small type of a model of the earth, okay, and it has horizontal lines and vertical lines. The horizontal lines are called the latitudes. Yesterday we have already discussed about these things. Latitudes are the horizontal lines, the parallel lines, and longitudes is our vertical lines, which coming from up from the top to the bottom of northern hemisphere to the southern, to the bottom of the southern hemisphere. And when these two lines are intersect, okay, cross each other, that is called a grid system. A grid, what is a grid system? A grid is a set of lines of latitudes and longitudes used to find the exact location of a place on the globe or a map. So when two lines are intersect or cross each other, they are called a grid. So latitudes is an horizontal line, a parallel line. I already told you a latitude is the angular distance of a point of the earth surface measured in degrees when from an imaginary lines. When these lines are the imaginary lines, they are made by the humans. They are the imaginary lines by the humans. And when there is angular distance measured on the globe, it always measured in kilometers, miles. How we can measure on a globe? How? Somebody raise your hand who knows the answer. Yesterday I already taught you that in how we can measure in kilometer or miles. Yes, Kisle, how we can measure? Yes, unmute yourself.
Sir, degree, by degree.
By degree, yes. We can measure
it. We can measure degree.
Yes, we can measure in degree. Very good, Kisle. And named the imaginary line, the center line of the latitude, the middle line of the latitude is called the equator. Remember that? The middle line which is passes through the earth is called an equator, which lies midway of the poles, in the middle of the poles, and it divides into two equal halves. So turn your page. This is all I have taught you yesterday. You have seen this picture of the globe of the earth, the latitude lines. These are parallel, equal parallel lines, and the middle line started with zero, and that is called 0 degree, and that is called the equator line. And the longitude line you have seen, this middle line is also a longitude line, and it divided by a prime meridian line. Then the grid line, grid system you have seen, the which is intersect two longitude and latitudes are passes, and it called a grid system. So and latitudes are the parallel lines to each other. And in other words, all the parallel circles from equator up to the poles are called parallel latitudes. And it is the distance between two parallel lines is assumed as 1 degree, that is equal to 111 kilometer. Okay, the northern half of the earth is called as northern hemisphere, and the southern half is called the southern hemisphere. Equator is the zero latitude and is the largest latitude. Then some now today we going to discuss about some important latitudes, some important about latitudes. Okay, so you where you have marked, from there we start some important latitudes. You have marked in your book yesterday. You have marked. Okay, so from there we will start some important latitudes. You will see in the picture this important latitudes. You have seen in the on the picture that there's two poles are there, North Pole and South Pole. And see, the Arctic Circle is very near to the, see in the picture, the Arctic Circle is very near to the North Pole. That means it is the closest to the North Pole, and North Pole is very coldest place. This Arctic Circle is very coldest place, and it is 66 degree and a half north. So you will see Arctic Circle, and then there is Tropic of Cancer, 22 and a half degree north. Then equator in the middle line, then the Tropic of Capricorn, after that the Arctic Circle near to the South Pole, and again this Arctic Circle is very coldest place. Why it is coldest, I come to you afterwards. First we will see these important latitude lines. The equator represent the zero latitudes. You will see written in the book, the equator represents 0 degree latitude. Then the Tropic of Cancer, 23 and a half degree north in the northern hemisphere, is called the Tropic of Cancer. The Tropic of Capricorn is 23 and a half degree south. This is 23 and a half degree south, 23 degree and a half degree north. These are all measurements of line. Okay, 1 degree is 111 kilometers. You all already know. So these are the degrees. These are the measurements of the what? This is the measurement of the this whole distance, this angular distance on the Earth. Then the Arctic Circle, 66 and a half degree north in the northern hemisphere, is called the Arctic Circle. Then Antarctic Circle, it is 66 and a half degree south in the southern hemisphere, is called the Antarctic Circle. North Pole, 90 degree north is the northern hemisphere, is called the Northern Pole. Southern Pole, South Pole, 90 degree south is the southern hemisphere, is called the Southern Pole, South Pole. These important latitudes divide the Earth into various heat zones. Now I already told you, I come to you on the picture that why it is very coldest. So in this line, the last line you have seen, it is written, these important latitudes divide the Earth into various heat zones. Means according to the lines, you will see according to the places, those places which are near to the equator are the hottest place, are all hottest place, because it is near to the sun. Direct, the rays of the sun fall directly on the equator. So this place, this 0 degree place, the equator place, is the hottest place. When you see this picture, important latitudes picture, you will see that this place, equator place, the equator line, which is divided the Earth into two equal halves, are the very hottest place, because the sun rays fall directly over the Earth. How? You will see on the board. First you will see on the board, you will see that this is the sun. You see this is the sun and this is the Earth. Okay, so the Earth divides into two equal halves, and it is called 0 degree, and it is an equator. This place, this line is an equator, and you will see this is sun. This is sun, and the you will see the distance. You will see the distance of the sun and the earth. This is earth. This ये क्या है हमारी earth है. This is this round circle is an earth. So you will see the rays of the sun. The distance of the rays is fall directly on the equator. दिखाई दे रहा है आप लोग को, है ना? Yes, and you will see now, then here and here. This is the rays. This is the rays. Now you will see that the shortest line is this. This middle line is the shortest line, means the rays of the sun falls directly, है ना? Shortest line means कि यहां पे earth जो है, the earth is very near to the sun. That is why it is shortest. ये पास में है, sun के पास में है. That is why this line is very short. And the longest line is here. Here is the north pole and the south pole. यहां रेस दूर से दूर पड़ रही है. द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द सन एंड द अर्थ, द रेज ऑफ द सन एंड द अर्थ फॉल टेक टाइम टू फॉल ऑन टू द अर्थ. इट टेक्स द रेज ऑफ द सन टेक लॉन्गर डिस्टेंस टू फॉल ऑन द अर्थ. ठीक है, ज्यादा टाइम ले रही है, ज्यादा लंबी लाइन है. दिस द रेज यू विल सी the line is very long, the distance is very long to reach the rays, to reach the earth, and this is the shortest line. So that is why this equator is the hottest, kyunki yahan pe jo hai, because the earth is very near and the sun rays fall directly, and the rays of the sun to the north pole and to the south pole is very far from the earth. The rays of the sun is very far, the earth is very far from the sun to the north pole and the south pole. That is why these two points, the north pole, these two poles are very coldest, are very coldest, kyunki wahan pe jo rays hai wo bahut der mein padti hai. The distance of the rays are very long. All of you understand what I am saying? If the sun rays fall directly, ठीक है, जो earth के पास, sun rays के पास है जो place, that place is the hottest place, and the which is far away from the sun, that means it is the coldest place. And so you will see that, or you will heard that the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circles are always covered with snow throughout the year. Pure snow se cover rehte hain pure saal. Why? Because the sun rays fall very little and it is very far from the sun. That place is very far from the sun. That is why this North Pole and South Pole, the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circles are very coldest, and the equator, the place near the equator are the hottest place, like the Thar Desert, you know, Sahara Desert. These are the deserts which are very near to the equator, and they are very, these places are very hottest, and these Antarctic places and Arctic places are the coldest place, and it covers with snow throughout the year. So this is the distance, and you will see, you also see in the degree also. This equator is 0 degree, and Tropic of Cancer 2.5 degree north, means it is also very near to the sun. You know, the distance of the from the sun is very close. But you will see the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle, the distance is very far from the equator also. You will see the distance very far, and it is very far from the sun also. The rays of the sun also get very less. See the 66 and a half degree south, and see the North Pole. It is also very far from the equator. That means it is very far from the sun. So 90 degree north and 90 degree south. So these places are very, these important latitudes divide the earth into various heat zone. This is the mean. Now come to longitudes. This is also an imaginary line, and it is a semicircle line. Longitudes, you will know that is a vertical line. You will see in the picture also, these are the vertical lines, and it is semicircle. You can see one side means the half of the circle is been measured. Half of the circle is been measured. Okay. So that half circle is called half circle. The half circle. You see the earth? This is the one side of the circle. You know, one side. So it is half circle, 180 degree. And the other side, there is one vertical line, means one longitude line, and that line is also 180 degree. Yesterday I told you. So ye idhar ki half line hai, and that when you see the other side of the earth, there is another 180 degree vertical line, means the longitude lines. As you see in the picture also, the one side is purple. See the picture, and the other side is colored with orange. So these half line is called the semicircle line. Half line is called the semicircle line. Other half line is also called the semicircle line. Okay, lines running from the imaginary semicircle lines running from North Pole to South Pole are called the longitudes. These are also called as meridians or lines, meridians or lines of longitudes. These are called meridian lines or lines of longitudes. Now, unlike the equator, see in the book, look into your books. Unlike the equator, which is centrally placed between the poles, any meridian can be taken as the zero line. It was finally decided in 1884 by an international agreement to choose as the zero meridian the one which passes through the British Royal Astronomical Observatory at Greenwich near London. This meridian is called the prime meridian, means this middle line, just like the latitudes, the middle line is called the equator. In this also, the middle line in longitude, the middle line is called the prime meridian. In latitude, the middle line which divides the earth into two equal half is called equator, and in longitudes, the vertical lines, longitude lines which divide the middle line which divides the earth into two equal half is called meridians, prime meridian. Okay, these meridians called the prime meridian, it is value is zero. In this also, the middle line is called zero. It starts with a zero. From this meridian, we count 180 eastward and 180 westward. Means the whole globe, the whole earth is 360 degree. 180 degree half semicircle, and the next half semicircle half is 180. 180 plus 180 is 360. The whole circle, the whole angular distance of the earth is 360 degree. Clear? Everyone clear? Turn your page. Now, characteristics of longitudes. The distance between any two meridians is measured in degrees. The degree is further divided into minutes, and minutes are divided into seconds. Okay, the distance between two meridians is measured in degrees. Again, these angular distances are measured in degrees. the degrees is further divided into minutes, and minutes are divided into seconds. By this we also get the time. There are 360 degree meridians or longitudes, 180 meridians in the east and 180 degree meridians in the west. The longitudes are semicircles equal in length, but they are not parallel. These lines are not parallel, just like the lines of latitudes. Latitude lines are parallel, but longitude lines are not parallel, but they are equal. They are equal, but not parallel. Then the distance between any two meridians or the longitude is not the same. It decreases steadily towards the poles and ultimately becomes zero at the poles where all the meridians meet. Means the where all the lines get going to meet means the here you will see this is the point where all the meridian lines meet and it is zero at that place. However, distance between the longitudes remains maximum at the equator. Lines at of longitudes are numbered from prime meridian. The imaginary is 0 degree line of longitude that extend from North Pole to South Pole and passes through the Royal Greenwich Observatory. Okay, so just outside London, the prime meridian divides the earth into two equal halves. As I told you that this prime meridian divides the earth into two equal halves, the eastern hemisphere and the western hemisphere. All right, then the alphabet E is used to indicate the eastern longitude and W is used to show the western longitudes. 180 degree E means east and 180 degree W means west. Longitudes are the same longitudes are referred to the 180 degree longitudes due to Earth's spherical shape. Earth's spherical shape, you will know the round solid figure is called the spherical shape of the Earth. Now longitudes and time. Finding time. How we can find time? The sun is the best timekeeper throughout the world. Earlier, people when there is no watch, they can watch the time, they can imagine the time by seeing the rays of the sun, by seeing the sun, the shadow, they will read what is the time. So time is measured on the basis of the relationship between the sun and the movement of the earth. As the earth rotates, you will see that the sun, in the morning, from where the sun rise, no, anyone knows? From where the sun rises? Yes, Shriangi. Shriangi?
Yes, sir.
From where the sun rises? From which side?
Sir, east.
Yes. And Agrima, and the sunset at which point? Which side? Agrima, unmute yourself.
So west.
West, yes. So it from east and set and in the west. So since the earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation, it passes through 15 degree in 1 hour or 1 degree in 4 minutes. The earth rotates from west to east. So every 15 degree we got eastward, the local time is the advance by 1 hour. And if we go westward, local time, we will be behind by 1 hour. In this way, we conclude that the places east of the Greenwich Meridian face the sun earlier and gain time, whereas the places that lie to the west of the Greenwich Meridian see the sun later and lose time. This is the table given in your book to see the time. Local time at the New York, 7:40 a.m. 4 hours 56 minutes behind. Okay, then in the noon, this is the difference of time. I have different places. Okay, now local time, the places situated on the same latitudes will have the same time, which is called the local time of all the places. Every place have different local times. Okay, so local time is calculated by the shadow cast by the sun. That is the shortest as the noon and longest at the sunrise and sunset. You will see the shortest rays will always fall in the noon time. Din ke samay sabse jo shadow, your shadow is very short in the daytime because the sun is at the top of your head. At the top of your head, sir, aapke sir ke upar sun is at your on your head and the shadow is very short. But in the when the sun rises and the one sun and the sunset time, the rays of the sun is, the shadow is very long. For example, when the prime meridian has the sun at the highest point in the sky, all the places along this meridian will have midday. That is, all the places on the given meridian of the longitudes have the same long local time. Now, Indian standard time. How we can see the Indian standard time? India lies between the longitudes of 68°7 and 97°25 east longitudes. There are 29 longitudes that lie between the east and the west. The longitude of 82.5° east or 82°30 east, which is just west of Mirzapur near Allahabad, is taken as a standard meridian and the local time as a longitude of 82.5° of east passes through almost the center of the country. Means this Indian standard line, this longitude lines passes through Mirzapur. The middle line of the longitude is passes through the through Mirzapur near Allahabad, and that prevails on that longitude is taken as the standard time for the whole country, and that line is being used to set the time, and that time is called the standard time of the whole country, of the whole India. This is called Indian standard time, or IST in short we can say Indian standard time. The Indian standard time, or IST, is 5:30 hours ahead of Greenwich mean time, Greenwich mean time is the standard time by which the other foreign countries like London have Greenwich mean time. By this they can divide the time. Okay, they set the time by the Greenwich time, and over here we have IST, Indian standard time. Then there is time zone. Like India, most country of the world adopt the standard time from the central meridians of their countries. Wherever the prime meridian or the meridian lines are passes, by that we can set the time. Okay, then in this way the entire world is divided into 24 standard time. Means we have divided the whole hour into 24. Means whole day is of 24 hours. 24 ghante ka ek din hota hai. So this whole zone is divided into 24 standard time zones everywhere, every place in every country, each of which differ from the next by 15° in longitudes or 1 hour in time. The international date line, IDL, in short we can say IDL, the international date line, is an imaginary line. These all are imaginary lines. Okay, that runs from the North Pole to the South Pole on the surface of the Earth. It passes through the middle of the Pacific Ocean. This international date time is passes through the Pacific Ocean. It roughly follows the 180 degree longitude and diverts slightly to pass along around some countries and island groups. Turn your page. The picture on the right, you will see the picture, then the international date line, IDL. The picture on the right clearly indicates that international date lines zigzag around the anti-meridians. Anti-meridians. You see, the lines are not very straight, they are zigzag. Okay, these IDL means international date lines are zigzag lines. If we move from the prime meridian towards the east, we shall find that the time is 12 hours ahead of the prime meridian or GMT. On the other hand, we shall find that the time at 180 degree meridian is 12 hours behind that of the prime meridian or GMT. However, both 180 degree east and 180 degree west are in the same meridian. This situation causes a lot of confusion. To clarify this confusion, 180 degree meridian has been declared as the international date line IDL as per the decision made by the International Meridian Conference in 1984. So these lines, that GMT line is very confusing line. So in the International Meridian Conference, the committee will set the international date line, the IDL, to all over the world, but to set the time. Okay, so this is the how we can locate places and see the time, and I hope you will understand and go through this chapters one again on Monday. If there is a class, SST class, you can clear your doubts on this chapter. And one thing more, I'm going to give you the exercise and question and answers in your PDF, and you can write the question answers in your fair copy. Correct? So all for today, I hope you will understand. Thank you. Stay safe. Bye-bye.